As a clinical professor of family medicine, I direct the reflective writing program for our family medicine clerkship. I'm also directing a resilience and well-being program for Boston Children's Hospital, Harvard Medical School for their child neurology residents. And I've been traveling around the country and also internationally to provide resilience well-being workshops, experiential sessions using some of the medical humanities, and speaking on this for various conferences. It's a very hot topic now. I'm very interested in the use of guided reflective writing to enhance reflection, which is a professional skill we all need, not navel gazing, but critical reflection, to be our own reflective coach in everything that we do, and also to help support our own professional identity formation, the story that we're crafting of ourselves and what we do. So I've been working on that at the medical school and for healthcare organizations, taking that on the road. And branching out with my clinical psychology background into how we can use reflective writing, mindful meditation and awareness, some of the emotional intelligence work for meaning and purpose and building resilience and well-being. So that's sort of it in a nutshell. I think that sometimes we don't think enough about what do we mean by professional competency, and there are these other emotional competencies. We say, I always like to say there's two pockets of the white coat. One is your technical skills knowledge, but the other pocket are those other competencies that we all need for our humanity, and that is our well-being and our mindful awareness, our resilience, our curiosity, our tolerating uncertainty and ambiguity, as you alluded to. So I think similarly, it's not just in medical professionals, but any professional out there working, entrepreneurs, for example, it's not no straight lines. We're always going to encounter some uncertainty or adversity. And resilience itself is about how do we adapt to that adversity? How do we take our strengths and work with that? That's a skill set. So I talk on mindset and skill set. Resilience as a mindset, growth as a mindset. We all are learning and changing, adapting to change as it comes our way. Knowing as an entrepreneur, when do you stick with it and when do you fold, right? These types of things. So I see it as a skill set that branches out beyond medicine, actually.